in jeopardy of being evicted. As someone who grew up in Section 8 housing and understands the threat of housing insecurity, I knew that I had to do something, which is why I joined Congresswoman Cori Bush and Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and several of our colleagues to demand that the Biden administration use its executive authority to reinstate the eviction moratorium. We were out at the Capitol steps late into the night, in some instances sleeping overnight, to elevate the issue of housing insecurity in the public consciousness and to get the White House to act. And it was thanks to our activism and the activism of so many grassroots organizers and everyone behind me here today who joined us on the Capitol steps or in their respective communities and who called on the White House to do the right thing, that it finally did do the right thing on Tuesday of this week by issuing a brand new 60-day eviction moratorium. This is a huge victory, and it will save lives, especially in the midst of a deadly pandemic with the Delta variant ravaging the same communities that bear the brunt of housing insecurity in this country. Earlier this year, I was proud to help pass the American Rescue Plan, which included tens of billions of dollars for the purpose of providing rental assistance to renters who were having difficulties paying their rent. And of course, landlords deserve to be made whole. We are doing both of these things. But to date, only $3 billion of that funding, of that $46 billion that Congress has appropriated, has actually been distributed by cities and other municipalities to renters and to landlords. This is unacceptable. And as I said, given the new 60-day period that we have, it is a prime opportunity for states like New York to do the right thing and to speed up the process of dispersing this money. That is why I sent a letter to the governor, joined by my colleagues in Congress from New York State, asking him to speed up the process of dispersing these funds. And it's why I'm also working with the State Office of Temporary and Disability Assistance for the purpose of speeding up that process. We need to continue to demand that they streamline and simplify the process of dispersing these funds, and that is my commitment to all of you today. Time is of the essence, and we need all of our leaders at the state and federal level to move with the urgency that the crisis demands. I also want to take a moment to speak directly to renters in Westchester and in Rockland counties who may be struggling to make rent. Help is here. If you are in need of rental assistance, please go to otda.ny.gov and click on Emergency Rental Assistance. Or you can call the following number, 844-NY1-RENT. As I said earlier, this week's victory was only made possible because of the advocacy of so many of the folks standing here today. And we are joined by advocates and activists and elected officials who have been bridging the gap to get our constituents the help and the information they need, and who represent the legal, social, and faith-based perspectives. Their presence here speaks to the scope and the urgency of this housing crisis and the dedication of those working to address it. We also have a brave constituent who will share her own story of housing insecurity. I'm so looking forward to introducing her later this afternoon. We will hear from all of them very shortly. But first, it is my pleasure to introduce